Alhamdulillah, brothers and sisters, we are starting our book 2 now. And as I had said many times, if you are strong in your Mubtada and Khabar, then this lesson is a halwa puri. If you are not strong in your Mubtada and Khabar, then this lesson is a hard chickpeas. You have a problem in digesting them. But inshallah, we know Mubtada and we know Khabar. And remember, when you talk about Khabar, Khabar is of 5 kinds. Huh? Khabar is of 5 kinds. Okay, brother, I write a sentence here. What did I write, brothers and sisters? Allahu Ghafurun Rahim. How will you translate? Allah is most forgiving and most merciful. Huh? Allahu. What is Allahu? Mubtada. What is it? Sahih. Where is the khabar? Ghafurun. And what is Rahimun? Is also khabar. When it comes to Allah, are you with me? We cannot say Rahimun is not. This is khabar number 2. Only when it comes to Allah, we'll be doing it more, inshallah, and we'll learn. Now I'm putting something in front of Allah. What is it, brother? What did I do? Inna Allah Ghafurun Rahim. What happened now? What happened to Allah? It was Allahu, it became Inna Allah. Who did that? Inna. So what is Inna? How do I define Inna? What do you define Inna as? Can you read? Harfu Tawqeedin wa Nasbin. How do you define Inna as? Harfu Tawqeedin wa Nasbin. What is Tawqeed, brother? Emphasis. What is Tawqeed? Emphasis. For emphasizing. And what is Nasbin? Something that will give the that will make the noun mansub. Remember, harf jar made the noun majrur. So harfu nasbin will make the noun mansub. Are you with me? Now mansub will come. Are you with me? Now mansub will come. Okay. So inna is a harf. What is harf? Particle. What is it? Particle of emphasis and making the noun mansub. Okay? That is what inna is. What is the meaning of inna? Truly, verily, surely, definitely. But brother, these meanings do not convey the same force and intensity as inna comes. Inna has its own sweetness and punch, and intensity. That one has to understand inna in Arabic only. Okay?
Tawqeed was?
Nasbin, brother. Tawqeed is emphasis. Tawqeed to Urdu mein tawqeed hai nahi hai. Sister Mehnaz, do we have tawqeed in Urdu? Tawqeed, Urdu? Yes. Tawqeed kehte hai, is tawqeed. Tawqeed is also correct. Nasbin is something which will make it, give it a nasab. It will give the noun a nasab. The noun has to come after inna.
Okay?
Mansub karega bhai.
Achha, masab.
Okay. Nasab means mansub. Huh? It will make it mansub. Do you see what happened to Allah? It became mansub. Are you with me? Inna Allah ghafirun rahim. Okay. Now brothers and sisters, look at it carefully. What is Allahu? What is Allahu? Mubtada. What is Allahu? Sahih. And what is Ghafurun? Khabar. Fine. Now Inna came. And it made the Allah Mansu. Now what is Allah? We won't call it Mubtada. Huh? Because Mubtadas are always Marfu. It is no longer Mubtada. What do we call it now? Here you have to understand. It is called Ismu Inna. What is it called? Ismu. Very simple. Ismu Inna. What is it? Allah is Ismu Inna. And I write down one more thing. Mansubun. And then what will I say to Ghafoor? It is Khabaru Inna. What did I write, brothers and sisters? So Mubtada will change into Ismu Inna if the Inna comes. So if you know Mubtada very well, you have no problem, because you know Mubtada change into Ismu Inna. And the khabar of Mubtada now, because it is coming with Inna, we will call it Khabru Inna. What you will call it? Is it any difficulty here? Huh? Sister Maimuna? Huh? Ismu Inna and Khabru Inna, khalas. Which was our Mubtada Khabar, now it changed into Ismu Inna and Khabru Inna. Are you with us, Sister Fatima? Mubtada, what Mubtada change into? What Mubtada change into? Ismu Inna. And what is the Khabar now called? Khabru Inna. That's all you have to remember. And as you know, the Khabar can be of five kinds. So if it is one word, then the Khabru Inna will be Marfu. Khabru Inna will be Marfu. If it is not one word, then Khabru Inna can be Shibu Jumla. Khabru Inna can be Jumla Ismiya. Khabru Inna can be Zarf, anything. We know Khabar of five kinds. So that knowledge will greatly help you. Okay? Fine, brothers and sisters, I give you more example. I write here example. Hamidun, Hamidun, Talibun. Huh? Sahi. What kind of a sentence is this? Jumla Ismiya. Huh? And it is Mubtada and Khabar. Where is Mubtada? Hamid. And Talibun is Khabar. Now Inna will always come in Jumla Ismiya. And the Jumla will remain Jumla Ismiya. When will Inna enter? Inna will enter into Jumla Ismiya. Huh? Because that's the way it is. When it comes into Jumla Ismiya, the Mubtada turns into Ismu Inna. Huh? Okay, brother? This is your Mubtada and your Khabar. Now put Inna. What shall I say now? Inna hamidan. What will you say? Inna hamidan. Inna hamidan. Then, what will I say? Talibun. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? So what will you say? Inna harfu tawqid wa nasbin. And what is hamidan? Ismu inna. And what is talibun? Khabar inna. That's all. Not a big deal here. Huh? Okay? Okay. Inna Allah ghafurun rahim. Inna Allah. Okay? Remove inna. It was Allahu. Fine, brothers and sisters? Okay. Now I come back to this. What is this, brother? What did I write down? Innahu Gafurun Rahim. Okay. Inna has come. Inna has come. Our brothers and sisters. So what is Inna? Inna harfu tawqid wa nasbin. Huh? What is who here? It is Ismu Inna. What is it? Ismu Inna. MashaAllah. Okay. It is. Are you with me? Ismu Inna. Okay. Ismu Inna is always Mansub. So who is here? Mansub. Remember, Kitabuhu, then who was? Mudaf ilayhi Majroor. Minhu, the who was? Ism Majroor. Because of preposition. But when it comes to same who, when it comes with an Inna, then the who is? Mansub. Why it is Mansub? Because of Inna. Are you with me? Because of Inna. So it is very simple, brother. Okay? So if I say here, Innahu Taliban. Talibun. Truly he is a student. So where is the Ismu Inna? Who? Is it Mansub? Yes. Why? Because Ismu Inna are always Mansub. Why? Because the Ismu Inna is always Mansub. Yes.
Why don't you put the Fatha then if it's Mansub?
Where?
Inna ha. Why don't you make it Inna ha? Oh, it's Mansub.
We'll put Inna ha.
Okay.
To satisfy Sister Salma. Now it will be. Okay, make it now. Innaha, what will happen here? Talibatun. Talibatun. Are you with me? Innaha, talibatun. See now, khabar matches. Do you see? Now, brothers and sisters, make it, they are students. What will you say? Innahum. Innahum tullabun. Are you with me? Now, let us make it into hunna. What will you say? Inna hunna talibatun. Are you with me? Brother, once you understand this concept, now you can go to Quran and wherever Inna comes, figure out where is the ism and where is the khabar. And you will love your exploration and your discoveries. Brother, are you with me? Where is Ismu Inna? Who? Where is Ismu Inna? Ha. Where is Ismu Inna? Whom? Where is Ismu Inna? Are they majroor or mansoob or marfu? Mansoob. Huh? We know inna will have mansoob. Fine, brother. Now, I write here something else. Sir. Where did I write, brothers and sisters? Anta talibun. Now let us put and emphasize it. So what will I say now? Innaka. Because you know, ta is a marfu. So what will you say? Innaka. See, now in the Quran we say, innaka anta sami'ul alim. So innaka, we are emphasizing it. When you say innaka, then he is in front of you. You are talking to him. Innaka anta tawwabu rahim. So anta was used for emphasize here. When it comes to the Quran, we will learn it. But innaka, truly you, talibun. Now I say, anti talibatun. What will I say now? Innaki. Khalas. Talibatun. Sahi, brother? Now, I am a student and I want to emphasize. Inni or innani. Both will be correct. Let us write down inni talibun. Nahnu. Inna na or inna. Inna tullabun. Sahi. Antum. Antum tullabun. I want to emphasize. Innakum. Now I want to emphasize sisters. Antunna talibatun. Inna. Brother, tell me, isn't it easy? Why you are doing it so fast? Because you have the idea of pronouns. You have the idea of pronouns. And you have the idea of mubtada khabar very well. That's it. That's the lesson, brother. That's the lesson. Okay? So once you understand with this foundation in you, things become easy, brother. And you are going to enjoy it. Now there are other complementary things with inna that I will show you inshallah tomorrow. Brother, there are so many beautiful things from Quran. If I'll tell you, you are going to love them. Okay. So is it clear, brother? What is inna? Harfu tawqid. Wa nasb. Say everybody together with me. What is inna? Harfu tawqid wa nasb. One more time. Harfu tawqid wa nasb. Say one more time. Harfu tawqid wa nasb. What is the translation in English? Particle of emphasis and making the noun mansub. That's all. That's all. Okay. And then mubtada will change into ismu inna. And the khabar will change into khabarinna. Khalas. That's all there is to be learned. Now, from now onwards, we will come to know that many of these things like inna and kana, they have sisters. What they have? So, inna wa akhwatu inna. We are going to learn. Sounds difficult? Akhwatu inna. Brother, inna is a badi behen. All are choti behne. Are you with me? So if the badi behen does something, the choti will follow the same rules. So it's not difficult. If inna does something, what does inna do? It makes its ism mansub. And it is called ismu inna. So if there are other sisters, for example, Anna. What is it? anna, inna. We are only learning inna now, but then we will learn anna. So if anna is there, it will have ism and it will have khabar. If you have lakinna, it will have ism and it will have khabar. Then ka'anna. These are all very simple and easy, provided you are strong in your mubtada and khabar. Okay? And then another thing. La'alla. What is it? La'alla. Okay? This is another sister of inna. Okay? La'allahu. So what is la'alla? Perhaps. Now la'alla has two meanings, but Dr. Abdurrahim takes his time to explain us. The first meaning is hope. What is it? Hope. The other meaning is fear. But then, as we will follow the book, we are not going to go outside the book in this case. We'll follow the book, brothers and sisters, and the la'alla meaning is hope. I ask you something. Kaifa haluka ya akhi? What is the meaning?
How are you?
And then I immediately say, la laka bi khair. I hope you are well. So la laka, I said, bi khair. Okay, brothers and sisters, you might say I'm jumping, but you know why? Even if I'm jumping, because I know you are strong. Okay, let me write down something. Are you with me, brother? Now, what is la'alla? Akhwatu inna. What is it? Akhwatu inna. So, what is ka now? Sister Maimuna, what is ka now? What is ka? Ka is a ismu la'alla. Because, are you with me? What is Abad Hasan? La'alla ka, what is ka? Ismu la'alla, because la'alla has come. And what does la'alla do? Whatever the older sister does, it gives the ism mansub, makes the ism mansub. That's her job. Okay, and we know khabar is of five kind. What kind of a khabar is this here? Bi khairin. Jar majur shibu jibla khabar. Are you with me? Now this is the khabar of la'alla. What is it? La'alla. Are you with me, brother? We can finish this lesson today. But we won't. Okay, are you with me? It's very, because you know it, because you are strong in your damair, it is very easy. Okay, brother? Let us start. Inna and put 14 damair. Innahu. Innahuma, innahum, innaha, innahuma, innahunna, innaka, innakuma, innakum, innaki, innakuma, innakunna, inni, inna. Are you with me? Inni, inna. Tell me, is it difficult? You can do it, brother. Let us do la'alla. La'allahu, la'allahuma, la'allahum, la'allaha, la'allahuma, la'allahunna, la'allaka, la'allakuma, la'allakum, la'allaki, la'allakuma, la'allakunna, la'alli, la'alli, and then la'allala, la'allala. La'allana. La'allana. Okay? So what were you doing here? We were just adding pronouns. And what are these pronouns now? Either if you put with inna, then it becomes ismu inna. If you put with la'alla, they become ismu la'alla. Okay. Now we are not doing it now, but just for the sake of fun and to tease you. Let us do lakinna. Ready? Lakinnahu, lakinnahuma, lakinnahum, lakinnaha, lakinnahuma, lakinnahum, lakinnaka, lakinnakuma, lakinnakum, lakinnaki, lakinnakuma, lakinnakunna, lakinnani, lakinnana. You will come across this in the Quran, brother. Left and right. What did you do? We added damair to lakinna. So damair became ismu lakinna. That's all. Ismu lakinna. Yes, Sister Arifa? Lakinnani. Lakinni you can say. So long as you give a shadda there. Okay? You can say. But shadda has to be there. Because sometimes, I don't want to say too much because I want you to go home with smiling. Not with too much of a stress. But. Okay. Father, this is it. Okay? So, in short, inna wa akhwatu inna will make the noun mansub. And noun has to come. It's a condition. If you are using inna, you have to have a jumla ismiya. And noun has to come. Okay? Later on, we will take Quranic verses and I'll tell you how beautiful the meaning becomes when you understand it. And how much you enjoy it, brothers and sisters. How much you enjoy it. Okay. You got the idea? Ismu inna and khabar inna, which were previously mubtada and khabar. Khalas, brother. That's it. And when you use damair with innahu, then those damair become ismu inna, and this time they are mansub. Khalas. That's it, brother. That's the whole lesson. Okay, fine. I'll give you one more with a definite noun. Brother? Al-Mudarrisu Jadidun. What is the translation? The teacher is new. What is Al-Mudarris? Mubtada. What is Jadidun? Khabar. Let us put now inna. Emphasize it. What shall I do now? Shall I make it in Al-Mudarrisi? What will I do now? Mudarrisa. See, our knowledge will help us in the Quran. Innal mudarrisa. Innal mudarrisa. What will happen to jadidun? Will it become jadidin? No. Khabar is marfu. Jadidun. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? So far, so good. Interesting. Sister Nasreen, not difficult. Because you know Mubtada Khabar. So, and you know your pronouns. Okay? Okay, brother? We start the lesson. And there are many things in the lesson. Newer things are coming. I'll explain you slowly, slowly. Brothers and sisters, we've got 15 minutes left. And we will try to do as much as we can. Otherwise, tomorrow we'll start from the lesson again. You have to say anything, Brother Abdul Samad?
Can you say you have to follow noun. Can you say inna fi kitabi?
Inna
fi kitabi. In this,
brother, fil kitabi, is fil kitabi muftada? No, then it cannot be ismu inna. But then, brother, I want to show you so many things. The one thing that I really want to show you tomorrow, if time permitting, brother, look at this sentence. And I want to explain you tomorrow. Brothers and sisters, you cannot translate Quran. You've got to understand it through the language and feel the sweetness of it. What is this? Innal insana. How many times we read this every day, I guess? Brother, inna, harfu tawqid. Wa nasmin. What is al insana? Ismu inna. So where is the khabar inna? Fi khusrin. What is it? Fi harf jar came? Harf jar? Ism. So khusrin became majrur. Every human being is in loss. But what is this la? That is another beautiful thing. Very beautiful thing. We learn in book 3. But we are going to learn tomorrow. Because if I explain you this concept of the la that comes, brother, it will make your reading of the Quran right away more interesting. And it is not difficult. It's so very easy that tomorrow when I'll explain you, you are going to be surprised. Inshallah. Okay? So the concept of inna is very important for us to understand, and you will understand without much difficulty. Because you have a strong foundation of Muftada. But suppose you did not have an idea of Muftada and Khabar. Then you will only be translating. You won't be understanding it fully. And if you did not have the idea of Damair, how they are attached, then you will not be able to say with confidence whether they are Majroor, Mansoob, what are they doing. You know, this way it becomes easy for you. Ready, brother and sister? Hashim, yes. Where is khabar marfu? Fi khusrin. Sister Nusrat. Remember, all of you, khabar is of how many kinds?
Five.
The scholars will say 3 kinds because they put shibu jumla together as one and al jumla, which is fi'liya and ismiya, as one. But I think for our simplicity, we say 5 kinds. Okay. Now, if it is not one word, then it is a shibu jumla khabar. So what is fi khusrin? Jar majrur, shibu jumla khabar. Khabar, kiski khabar hai? Inna ki. It is the khabar of inna. Remember, ismu inna and khabar inna. Don't confuse. Get confused, okay? Ismu inna and khabar inna. So when you will see inna in the Quran, just like we say if there is a fi'l, there is a fa'il. If there is a mubtada, there is a khabar. If there is a ismu, if there is a inna, then we have to have a ismu inna. And then we got to look for the khabar inna. Where is the khabar inna? In this case, inna al-insana. What is al-insana? Ismu inna. Fi khusrin khabar inna. Are you with me, brother? This is very easy. Brother, things will become so beautiful and interesting, inshallah. Okay? Now, I beg your pardon? Yeah, khabar inna is always marfu. Are you with me? Khabar inna is always marfu. That is why I say this is so easy. And you see, that is the beauty of Dr. Abdurrahim's book, his vision, how he wants to teach us. He starts with Muftada khabar in whole of book 1. Then we come to book 2. He starts with inna, because inna enters jumla ismiya, changes into muftada, makes muftada mansub, and we call now that muftada, what do we call it? Ismu inna. And khabar remains marfu, so we call it khabar inna. Khalas. Are you with me? About the other side? Is there any confusion? Okay, what is Mubtada? Is it Mubtada Marfu or Mansub? Marfu. What is Khabar? Is this Khabar Marfu or? One word, it is Marfu. Now come Inna. Inna only has an effect on Mubtada. It will make Mubtada Mansub. We won't call it anymore that thing Mubtada. We will call it Ismu Inna. And it is Mansub. And then Khabar is Marfu, still Marfu. But if you look at this, Inna Allaha Ghafurun Rahim, what do you see there, Brother Farooq? What is, do you see Ghafurun? Khabar, what is it? Dun dan din, what is it? Marfu, that's it. So you have to remember that. Those are the rules. These are the rules, brother. Ismu Inna, Mansub. Khabar Inna, if it is one word, Marfu. Or it can be Shibu Jumla. Inna is harfu tawqidin wa nasbin. And then the is, that the noun that will come after inna will become mansub. And what are we going to call it? Ismu inna. Khalas. That's all. Yes, Sister Salma.
Is it okay then to remember for ourselves that the noun following inna is always in the Mubtada?
Yeah, it used to be Mubtada.
Now
it is Ismu Inna, yeah. Why? Because Inna enters Jumla Ismiya. Inna will only enter Jumla Ismiya. It will not enter Jumla Failiya.
It is the immediate next noun.
Yes. Okay. If it is not next noun, then it can be a mile away.
Okay, that's what I wanted to know.
Okay. Here is a beautiful example that we are going to learn later on. Brother and sister, you are going to, inshallah, one day memorize this surah. This is the last ruku of Ali Imran. What is it? Last ruku of Ali Imran. Most of you know it, you know. Sister Mahnaz, probably you know it. Inna fi khalqi samawati wal ard wa ikhtilafil layli wan nahari. Brother, immediately after inna came fi. Huh? It came fi samawati, jar majrur. Okay? Are you with me? So can fis samawati be ismu inna? No way, it is jar majrur. It has to be a noun. So now we are going to look where the noun is. Are you with me? Noun is, okay? So a noun can be a half a kilometer away. The ismu inna can be further down. Are you with me? I don't want to go too much in detail. Just wait, brothers and sisters. And as soon as you are ready, we will bring Quranic verses. And there are so many. And inshallah, that is our reason why we are studying language of the Quran, to understand the Quran. Okay, brother. Hashim, he is a student. Huh? Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hashim is now asking the teacher, Kaifa? Halu ka. Now you see, you will be able to, you won't say kaifa hali. No, you say kaifa halu ka. Ya ustad. And afterwards, what does he say? La laka bi khair. Means, I hope you are well. So brother, la la came. What is la la? Min akhwatu inna. Okay, fine. Okay. And then what is ka? Ismu la la mansub. And where is the khabar la alla? Bikhair, I wrote it down, isn't it? Huh? La alla ka bi is the khabar of what? Jar majur shibu jumla khabar la alla. Aap samjhe? It's very simple. Sometimes I don't write. I think you will be able to match it. Fine. Alhamdulillah. What is the answer? Alhamdulillah. But what is alhamdulillah? Mubtada, jar majur shibu jumla khabar. وَكَيْفَ حَالُكَ أَنْتَ يَا هَاشِمْ. And how are you? See, if the Ustad has said, وَكَيْفَ حَالُكَ يَا هَاشِمْ, it is perfect. But he says, كَيْفَ حَالُكَ, and he using أَنْتَ. Now, أَنْتَ usually comes in the beginning. Here, the أَنْتَ is used for emphasis. How are you? You, O Hisham. Are you with me? So here anta is for taqid. What will you say? For taqid, keh de aap. Okay, fine. Hashim, fine. Ana uhibbuka kathiran. What a beautiful. Ana. Mubtada. What is uhibbu? This is your verb. It's in present tense. We haven't learned it. We are not going to go in detail, brother. Only I would say uhibbuka, I love. Love whom? Ka. So ka is your mafulun bihi. Ka is an object of. Would you like to write it down? Just write down that. No further explanation. Ka is an object. Isme mat likhenge. Aapki, you know, kitab. Tomorrow we are going to do it again, inshallah. Okay. Oh, what is kathiran? Mansub hai. Kathiran. Do you remember? Anybody remembers? Ah, mashallah. Mafoolun mutlak. Now, what is the actual meaning? We are going to do later on. But it is maful. See, now you remember, huh? That this is mafoolun mutlak. Mashallah, that was excellent, Brother Abdussam. Mashallah, fine. Innaka talibun zakiyun. What is it? Innaka. See, now comes innaka. So what will you say, Brother Hassan? Inna is arfu taqid wa nasbin. What is ka? Ismu inna mansub. Sahi, what will you say ka? Ismu inna mansub. Where is the khabar? Talibun is your khabar. One word. Okay, then after talibun comes zakiyun. What is zakiyun, Brother Abdul Samad? It is a naat. Talibun zakiyun. Now comes mujtahidun. Also naat. But these are all mautufun ala zaki. Okay. And then wazlu. Now zlu is also a naat. And it is mautufun ala zakiyun. And then wahua mudaf. And then mudaf ilayhi. Brothers and sisters, I told you that we have so far studied ayu, and then we studied kullu. Now we are studying zu. They will come as a mudaf. There will be mudaf ilayhi. Are you with me? There will be mudaf ilayhi. Now the tricky thing is, if you really want to understand well, and I always felt that I should understand well, you know, when I was studying. I want to know everything, even though it is hard. You have to watch that zu, which is a mudaf, can come as a naat, or can come as a khabar also. It will come as a khabar, or it can come as a naat. Doesn't matter, whatever way it comes, it will always have mudaf ilayhi. Because it has mudaf ilayhi. Whether it comes as a khabar, or whether it comes as a naat, it will have mudaf ilayhi. So look at this sentence, brother. There is a beautiful exercise coming. Now, this requires a little bit of understanding and a little bit of extra penetrating. Okay. Now look at here. We already got talibun as a khabar. Then zakiyun came as a naat. And then mujtahidun also is a naat, but mautufun ala zakiyun. Then again ataf came. Again, zu is a naat, but it is mautufun ala zakiyun. So it is a naat. Now there will be sentences in which it will become khabar. And we have to watch. We have to watch. Zu khulqin. Zu means owner or possessor. Brother? Literal meaning is owner or possessor. When you say Zu Khulukin means he has good character, with a good character. There are things that will surprise you when you understand Zu very well. Because you always say, Ya Zal Jalali, Zal Jalali Wal Ikram. So what is this Ya Zal Jalali? What is this? Zu became Zah. Zu became Zah. All these things we will study and it will surprise you, brother. That these things we used to say it all the time but never understood the meaning of or the construction of it. Fine, brothers and sisters. Amin Pakistan anta, am min al Hindi. No, I want you to really underline min Pakistan. And I want you to underline Minal Hindi, brothers and sisters. Okay, this is also a concept that has to be understood. What is Ah, brother? Ah is called Harfu Istifham. Brother Abdul Samad? Ah is for asking question. And what is Am? Am means or. Am. There is another word, aw. They both mean or. Now we have to remember one thing, that am is only used in questions. And aw is used in statements. Statement. When you use a question and you have to use or, then you'll use am. When you have to say a statement and use or, you'll use aw. So what is so special about this? I want to explain, brother. Amin Pakistan anta, am min al Hindi. In a sentence, when you are not sure and you ask a question and you state two things. How many things? Two things. Okay. This or that. Because you're not sure. So in Arabic language, brother, the two things that you want to inquire about, first thing will come after a. Are you with me? Here is, brother, I'm not too sure whether he's from Min Pakistan. And the other thing is Minal Hindi. I'm not too sure. Okay. Are there two things that you are inquiring? Then immediately after a, one will come. Are you with me? So immediately after a, I say a, min, bakis, tana, and then anta. Am, then the second thing. Number one I'm inquiring about and number two. And there are two things. One and two. Are you with me? How will you say in English? Are you from Pakistan or Pakistan or from India? See, these things came together and in the middle is or. Sahi? Are you from Pakistan or India? Okay? They came together with the or dividing them. Can I say the same thing in Arabic? Anta min Pakistana am min al-Hindi? I can say that, you know. Anta min Pakistana am min al-Hindi? But that will be wrong. That will be very poor Arabic. The eloquent Arabic will be that we divide those two things, we bring one soon after a, and the other thing after am. Are you following me, brother? Is this clear? Instead of saying anta, no, I don't say anta. I bring that one thing. Amin Pakistan anta. Amin Pakistan anta. Am min al-Hindi. That will be a most correct form. You have to remember this. This is how when you ask about two things, then this is the way you will say it. Now, here is, I don't know whether this thing is a masjid or a school. They both look same. So I say, Ahada masjidun am madrasatun, but that will be incorrect. A masjidun haza, a madrasatun, am madrasatun. Are you with me? A masjidun haza, am madrasatun. I write down this sentence. Two things, brother. A masjidun haza, and then I'm writing here am madrasatun. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Let me write down with this black. What will you say in English? Is this a masjid or a school? So masjid or a school came together. But in Arabic, a masjidun haza. Not a haza masjidun. You will say a masjidun haza am madrasatun. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Write down these two. They are coming in the lesson. There is a whole exercise coming to tell us. Now this is the eloquent way of saying it. If you say it the other way, ahada masjidun am madrasatun, is a very poor Arabic. A person will understand you, but that is not correct. That is incorrect. You will say a masjidun haza am madrasatun. So similarly here, we don't know whether he's from Pakistan or from India. So we are asking min Pakistan anta am min al-Hindi. That is the correct way of asking. Inshallah, you will remember, brothers and sisters. You will read this lesson. I used to read book 2 often, brother, because the lessons are beautiful and they are beautiful dialogues. So one can enjoy reading them over and over again, brothers and sisters. What is the answer of Hashim? Inni min al-Hindi. Now what is inni? How many words are there? There are two words, brothers and sisters. Okay, what is it? Sister Sukhaina, inna and plus ya mutakallim. Sister Hafza, did you get it? Inni is two words. Inna plus ya mutakallim. So inna, what is inna? Harfu taqid wa nasb. And what is ya mutakallim, Sister Hafza? Ismu inna mansubun, mashallah. May Allah bless you, sister, and all of us. MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Very good. And then where is our khabar, Sister Hafsa? Min al-Hindi, what is min al-Hindi? Jar marjur shubu jumla khabar. MashaAllah. That's the way it is. I like it. Okay. Wazamiluka. Wazamiluka. وَذَمِلُكَ الَّذِي خَرَجَ مَاكَ الْآنَ مِنَ الْفَصْلِ Brother, only translate this. Do not try to analyze it. Because questions we don't analyze. وَذَمِلُكَ الَّذِي خَرَجَ مَاكَ الْآنَ مِنَ الْفَصْلِ How will you translate, Brother Abdus-Samad? So this is the translation. And your colleague who came out with you now from the class, ahuwa aidan, is he also min al hindi? No, what is the answer? La, innahu min Pakistan. See how cleverly Dr. Sahib is using those pronouns in the dialogue, and we are getting the practice of all our pronouns, you know. Dr. Sahib will use all the pronouns except dual. He will not use dual now, till at the end of the book. But for the sake of practice and simplicity and the sequence, when we practice, we do 14 in a sequence, brother. Okay. Innahu min Pakistan. Inna. Sumaya, what is inna? Harfu taqid wa nasb. What is who? Ismu inna mansub. MashaAllah. And where is khabar inna? Min Pakistan. What is min Pakistan, sister? Jar majrur, shubu jumla khabar. InshaAllah, I'm going to ask everyone. And inshaAllah, you'll try to answer me. If you get confused, don't worry, it's normal. But I would like you to make an attempt, and inshaAllah, you will become strong. Now Al-Mudarris is saying, what is he saying? Inna. After inna, there is no pronoun, but a noun is coming. So inna will make that noun mansub. And we will call that noun ismu inna. So what is inna? Sa'ata. It is sa'atu. Sa'atu became sa'ata. Now that is our ismu inna. Wahuwa mudaf. And what is ka? Mudafili. Inna sa'ataka. Jamilatun. Okay, Sister Fatima, what is jamilatun? Jamilatun. It's one word. So it is a khabar inna. What is it? Khabar inna. We got our ismu inna sa'ata. Wahuwa mudaf. Mudafilihi. Aminal yabani here. See, this is the proper way of saying. If you say, ahiya minal yabani, it's not right. Minal yabani hiya? Are you with me? Minal yabani hiya? What is the answer? La. And then, innaha. Sister Fatima, what is inna? Harfu tawqid wa nasb. And what is ha? Ismu inna. Mansubun. Got your ismu inna? Where is your khabar inna? Min al hindi. What is it? Jar majur, shubu jumla khabar. MashaAllah. Now see how the question is asked. You are asking, you don't know whether it is cheap or expensive. In English, you will say, is it inexpensive or expensive? Inexpensive or expensive will come together in English. But in Arabic, we will say, Aghaliyatun hiya. What will you say in Arabic, brother? Aghaliyatun hiya. Am rakhisatun. So here comes a and am. Now we cannot say a hiya. No, we will say, Aghaliyatun hiya. Am rakhisatun. Got the idea? Watch for this construction, brother and sister. Aghaliyatun hiya am rakhisatun. So between a and am, The two things that we are inquiring, one will come immediately after a, and then the other thing will come after am, and everything else in between. This construction is very important to keep it in mind. Inshallah. Innaha rahisatun jiddan. Innaha rahisatun jiddan. See, rahisatun. Tun. Okay. Marfu. Okay. So, Sister Naima, what is innaha? How many words are there? Two. What is inna? Harfu taqid wa nasbin. Well, what is ha? Ismu inna mansu. And what is, where is our khabar? Rakhisa tun. That is your khabar, one word, marfu. And what is jiddan? Jiddan is jiddan, marfu, mansub, majroor. Mansub, it is mansub. So there it is something else. And it is mafulun mutlaq. We will read it and understand it later on. Don't worry. I will be saying mafulun mutlaq so many times. You will become expert in saying mafulun mutlaq. And you will even figure out that it is mafulun mutlaq. The only thing you won't know is why. And that we will learn later on in book 3. Okay, brothers and sisters. Innaha, Sister Faiza, innaha bi miyati rubiyatin fakat. No, brother and sisters, the word fakat means only. It's a very common word, fakat. It has never been used in Quran. Fakat has never come in Quran. Okay? But we use fakat all the time in our conversation. And keep that in mind, brother. So, Sister Faiza, innaha, how many words are there? Two. What are they? Inna. MashaAllah, ismu inna, mansub. You will always say mansub because we want to have that idea of mansub in our mind. Ha is ismu inna mansub. No, where is our khabar? What is bi? Miyati. Bi miyati. Huh? Bi, what is bi? Harfchar. So miyati became ism majrur. Harfchar ism majrur. So this bi miyati, brothers and sisters, is your jar majur shibu jumla khabar. And what is rubiyatin? See, bi miyati with single kasra. Now rubiyatin came with a tanwi kasra. Can you figure out? Brothers and sisters, rubiyatin is mudafilehi. What is it? Now let me show you something, brother. Keep this in mind, brother. What did I write down, brother? Yes. Miyatun. I wrote alif, but I did not pronounce. Huh? So miyatun, the spelling is this. In some countries, they write down like this. They don't write with alif. Both are correct. But let us stick to this, because this you'll find in many literary works. Okay? Mia tin. And in Quran also you find like that. So you are not pronouncing this alif. Huh? So look at it, mia tun. The same goes with alfun. 100 and 1,000. Now always it, because it's a number, we will have ma'dud. Huh? So what will be? Miyatun talibin. What did I? Miyatu. Because now it becomes mudaf. Are you with me? Miyatu talibin became mudaf. Mudafilehi. Miyatu talibin. Sahi? What is it, brother? Mudaf. Mudafilehi. Sahi? Right? Fine. And what if I were to say 100 female students, still Miyatu will remain Miyatu. Only the Ma'dud will change. only the ma'dud will change. Sahih? Miyatu talibin and miyatu talibatin. No change in miyatu. Same way I say alfu talibin and I will say alfu talibatin. Got the idea, brother and sister? Alfu talibatin. Sahi? It will remain same. Now, sister Faiza, I say here miyatu rubiyatin. See? Miyatu rubiyatin. Or miyatu dularin. Miyatu dularin. Okay? So what is miyatu? Mudaf. Rubiyatin? Mudafile. Now I put harf jar in front of it. B. What did I put? B. So what is B? Harf jar. How many words are there now? Three words are there. Remember? Three there. So what is harf B? Harf jar. Then we have to have a ism majroor. So where is the ism majroor? Miyati. Now I will give it a kasra. Maybe I should and put here B in the red and then I will give it kasra here. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? B miyati. Okay. Now there are two compounds. B miyati jar majroor and miyati rubiyatin mudaf mudafili. So miyati is playing now double role. Are you with me? It's playing double role. So it is B miyati, B harf jar, miyati ism majroor, wahua mudaf, and then rubiyatin mudafilihi. Got the idea, brother? Are you with me? One more time I say B harchar miyati ism majroor wahua mudaf. Because it is mudaf also. And then mudafili. Maybe I should write down. B, brothers and sisters. Harfu jar. Harfu jarin. Miyati ism majroor. Plus it is mudaf. And then this is mudaf ilayhi. Got the idea, brother and sister? So, sister Faiza, if you say, inna harfu taqidin wa nasbin, ha, ismu inna mansub, b, harf jar, miyati ism majroor, shibu jumla khabar. Sahi? Shibu jumla khabar. And then what will you say? Rubiyatin on its own, mudafilehi. Sahi? In the end, it was mudafilehi. Sahi? Are you with me, brother Muhammad? Right? It's not difficult, brother. And once you will get used to this, brother, you are going to love book 3. You are going to love it. Because things will become so clear to you. You know? And then you are going to enjoy it. Now comes our same, come akhan laka. What is akhan, brother and sister? Mansub, singular, indefinite. What is akhan? Tamiz, mashallah. What is it? Tamiz. Kam akhan laka ya Hashim. How will you translate? Mudarris is asking. How many brothers you have, O Hashim? What is the answer? Li salasatu ikhwatin. Okay, brother, we have done it in book 1. How many words are in Li, sister Arifa? Two words. What are they? Ism, jar, majroor. They are jar, majroor. Li is harf jar. Ya mutakallam is ism, majroor. Jar, majroor, shubu jumla khabar. Now, where is our muftada? Salasatu. Wahua muda. And then, mudafili. MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Now the question, At-tullabun hum. Watch this. How the ahum, we are tempted to say ahum tullabun. No, brother. At-tullabun hum should be the proper way of asking. At-tullabun hum? Fine. What is the answer, Sister Maimuna? La. Innahum tujjarun. Are you with me? Innahum tujjarun. So, innahum, how many words are there? Two. What are they, sister? Inna, harfu taqid wa nasbin, and hum, ismu inna, mansubun, mashallah. And you see, it is ismu inna is mansub, so the khabar, brother and sister, is marfu, tujjarun. Tujjarun. In other words, if there is a one word coming as a khabar of inna, it will always be marfu. Marfu. Okay. Now one more thing, brothers and sisters. If I did not say inna, what will I say? Hum tujjarun. What will I say? Hum tujjarun. So if the muftada is jama, the khabar is also jama. That is also we have to bear in mind. Fine. So tujjarun is a khabar inna. Mashallah, mashallah. Kam ukhtan laka. How do you translate, Sister Nasreen? Sisters you have. Fine. What is the answer? Li arba'u akhawatin. Li, how many words are there? Two. What are they? An ism majroor. Jar majroor. Fine. Shubhu jumla khabar. Where is our mubtada? Arba'u. Wahua mudaf. And where is mudaf ilahi? Akhawatin. Akhawatin. Tin. Tin. Mudaf ilahi majroor. Tin. Very good, mashallah. Afil hindi hunna. Al-ana, afil hindi, hunna al-ana. What is the translation? Are they in India now? What is the answer, Sister Mahanas? La. Inna hunna huna bil madinatil munawwarati ma abi wa ummi. Oh, but you got a long sentence. I did not pull it for you. It came in your share as we are going along. So, inna hunna, how many words are there? Can you describe them? Nasbin, hunna, mashallah. Where is our khabar hunna? Now, be careful. There are many possibilities. But hunna, huna, inna hunna, huna is zarf. Zarfu, makan. Hunna. Okay, khabar, the more appropriate khabar will be bil madinatil munawwarati. Look at it. Innahunna bil madinatil munawwarati. They are in Madina. Fine. Bil madinati. What is this, sister? Shibu jumla khabar. What is al munawwarati? Not mashallah, mashallah. And what is this ma doing here? What is ma? Zarf. So then after ma, we should have a mudafili. What is abi? How many words are there? Two. So how will you describe ma abi? What is ma? Zarf. And after zarf will come mudafili majroor. So abi here is two words. Abi with kasra, not abu. We won't say abu. You know why we won't say abu? Because ma has come, it made abu into abi already. Okay? Are you with me? Okay. Look here. Ma. Okay. And then Abi and plus Ya Mutakalim. Are you with me? So normally we are, when we say Abi, we always say it is Mubtada and it is Marfu, Abu. But in this case, because Ma came, Ma will already change Abu into Abi. Then Abi is our, because of ma is mudaf ilayhi. Plus it is mudaf for ya mutakallam mudaf ilayhi. Is it clear, Brother Abdul Samad? Ma when came, it needs mudaf ilayhi. So abi became mudaf ilayhi for ma. And then it is mudaf for ya. Same thing. See, abi is now playing double role. On one hand, it is mudaf ilayhi, and then it is turning around and saying, I am mudaf also. And ya mutakallim became mudaf ilayhi. Okay, then again, waw came. Ataf. So what is ummi? Ummi will be mautufun ala abi. Wa huwa mudaf, and ya mutakallim mudaf ilayhi. Sahi? Very good. Ataribatuhunna. Nusrat, what is the translation? We cannot say ahunna talibatun. No. The more eloquent is atalibatun hunna. Are they students? Yeah? La. Inna hunna. Mudarrisatun. Bil madrasatil thanaviyati. Bil madrasatil thanaviyati. إِنَّهُنَّ مُدَرِّسَاتٌ بِالْمَدْرَسَةِ الثَّانَوِيَّةِ Okay? حَرْفُ نَفِي ٹھیک ہے حَرْفُ تَوْكِيد وَنَسْبِ منصوب Where is the خَبَرِنَّ مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ And بِالْمَدْرَسَةِ جَارْ مَجْرُور Char Majur, Sahi, and Sanaviyati, Naat, MashaAllah. You got the idea, brothers and sisters? Alhamdulillah. Now, Ajib Anil As'ilatil Atiyati. Okay, brother? You will have to read the lesson properly and answer them. If you read it two times, you will be able to answer them properly. Min Aina Hashimun. Huwa, you can say huwa or you can say innahu. But huwa will be correct, innahu will be correct. Huwa minal hindi. Ayyuhibuhu al-mudarrisu. Ayyuhibuhu al-mudarrisu. See, yuhibu is also a verb. We have not studied. Who with yuhibu is object. Mafhul bihi. We have not studied. So we don't worry. Al-mudarrisu. It is your file for yuhibbu. So our answer will be simple. Naam, yuhibbuhu al-mudarrisu kathiran. What will you say? Yuhibbuhu al-mudarrisu and then add kathiran at the end. So yuhibbuhu al-mudarrisu kathiran. Now if you write down, brothers and sisters, I divide it, What is yuhibbu? This is your fi'l. What is it? Your fi'l. And this we have not studied, but this is your object. In Arabic we call it maf'ulun bihi. In lesson 5 you will understand. Before we break for our Eid holidays, I'm sure we will do lesson 5. By that time we will be done with it. Maybe even lesson 10. I will just write down maf'ulun Bihi. Later on you will become expert inshallah. And what is al-mudarrisu bada samad? See where the verb came. When verb comes, what are we looking for?
We look at file and...
File. Yes. So yuhibbu is your fi'l.
Yes.
Yuhibbu is your fi'l. So it is our file. Who is mafulun bihi, brother? Al-mudarrisu. Remember that, Al-mudarrisu is your file. Who is connected with verb? I know this is going too far. If I'm expecting too much from you. But don't worry. If I don't explain you this much, brothers and sisters, then you will be confused in answering it. I was very confused in understanding yuhibbuhu al-mudarrisu. Because I was always looking for answers. If it is al-mudarrisu and it is marfu, I wanted to know why it is marfu. This is not a Jumla Ismiya, there is no Mubtada Khabar. Then, you know, once I came to know, it made me feel good, you know, and I thought I should explain you. So, brother and sister, yuhibbu is your verb, which makes this sentence Jumla Failure. And who is your maf'ulun bihi? We are going to learn about it very soon. So don't worry. Just it is, what is the English of maf'ulun bihi? Object. Object of the verb. Maf'ulun. We are going to learn very soon, brother. Inshallah. I am anxious to jump to lesson 5. I wish I can do it tomorrow with you. Lesson 5. But we will wait. And then al-mudarrisu is marfu. It is marfu because it is it is the file. Verb needs a file. So if the yuhibbu is the verb, where is the file? Al-mudarrisu. And then kathiran is a lot, which is mafulun mutla. How will I translate? The teacher loves him very much. What did I say? Sister Fatima, the teacher loves, this is present tense, loves him a lot. The question is, yuhibbu hul mudarrisu, does the teacher love him? Okay, write down. Write down, yuhibbu hul mudarrisu, does the teacher love him? What is your answer? Naam. Yuhibbu hul mudarrisu kathiran, the teacher loves him a lot. Are you with me? So, ayyuhibbu hul mudarrisu, what is the translation? Does the teacher love him? Who is him? Does the teacher love him? And we say, yes, the teacher loves him very much. Are you with me? Naam, yuhibbu hul mudarrisu kaseeran. That's all. That should be enough. Once we do lesson number 5, brothers and sisters, inshallah, it will be okay. Once we do lesson number 5, inshallah, it will be okay. Now, brothers and sisters, what is it? Min aina sa'atuhu? Min aina sa'atuhu? What will you say? Either you say, hiya, min al Hindi, or you can say, innaha, min al Hindi. Sahi? Fine, brother. Become here. How much is it for? What will you say? Here be rubia miati rubiatin. Here be miati rubiatin. Miati, single kasra. Fine. Kam akhan lahu. What will you say? Kam akhan lahu. You'll say lahu. Are you with me? How will you answer? Lahu salasatu ikhwatin. Salasatu. So, agar our numbers are still coming with us. Lahu salasatu ikhwatin. Very good, brother. Kam ukhtan lahu? Lahu arba'u akhawatin. See, we are getting our practice of numbers. Lahu arba'u arba'u akhwatin. Aina akhwatuhu? Aina akhwatuhu? Akhwatu. Akhwatu. Sisters. Now here you have to say, brother, hunna bil madinatil munawara. What will you say? Hunna, they are bil madinatil munawara. That will be the most simple and suitable answer. Okay. Try to give simple answers. You know why, brother? Why I ask you to give simple answers? Simple answers? Because the life is already very complicated. Don't make our life more complicated by giving complicated answers, you know. Just try to make simple answers. Fine, brother. Now, this exercise is very simple and it is interesting. Da hadhihi al-alamata. Give this sign, amam al-jumla sahih. in front of the correct sentence, وَهَذِهِ الْعَلَامَةَ and X sign, أَمَامَ جُبْلَ الَّتِي لَيْسَتْ صَحِيحَةً. Okay? Number one, هَاشِمٌ طَالِبٌ كَثْلَانُ. Brother Muhammad, is this sentence right or wrong?
Right.
This sentence is wrong because Hashim, Talibun, Mujtahidun. What is it?
Mujtahidun.
Brother, he's a hardworking student. So this sentence is wrong. It is only from the lesson. Did you understand the lesson well? If you understood the lesson well, then you will say this sentence is not right. Hashimun, Talibun, Mujtahidun. Fine. Now, see, now you can do two sentences. What is this? Hashimun, Talibun, Mujtahidun. Is this sentence correct?
Yes.
This is correct. Sahih? Right. Fine, brother. Now, Saatuhu Rakhisatun. Brother Hassan, Saatuhu Rakhisatun. His watch is inexpensive. Is it correct?
No.
It is correct. Huh? What about the Saatu Ghaliyatun? It is incorrect. Sahih? So this is what you have to say. But you must understand and translate it. Saatuhu galiyatun. How will you translate? Saatuhu, his watch. It's not a question, it's a statement. We are only translating. Saatuhu, his watch. Galiyatun is expensive. No, that is not correct. Saatuhu rakhisatun, his watch is inexpensive. That is correct. Brother Abdul Samad. Saatuhu bi alfi rubiyatin. Is this correct?
No.
No. What is the translation of Saatuhu? His watch is for 1,000 rupees. No, that's incorrect. Saatuhu bi miyati rubiyatin. Remember miyati, rubiyatin. So, his watch is 100. Is this correct?
Yes.
It is correct. Now, brother Saeed. Akhwatuhu bil madinatil munawwara. His sisters are in Madina Munawwara. That's correct. Akhwatuhu bil Hind. That is not correct. His sisters are in India. Bil, B can also mean in also. Bil Hind. Fine, brother. That is very, very easy. It's the statement which are being given and we are being asked, are these statements correct? So if we understood the lesson very well, then we can figure out the statements are correct or incorrect. Sister Halima, now this is to you comes halwa puri. Brother, sister, ta'ammal. Okay? Ta'ammal. Ma yali means ponder what follows. Brother, inna plus huwa becomes inna. Come on, give me a break. I know that. So brother, all of this, do you see how easy it has become for you? Okay, I will ask you only one thing. What is innahu? Two words. What are they? Inna, harfu taqid wa nas, and huwa, ismu inna mansub. What is innaha? Same thing. What is innaka? Same thing. So these are all very easy. And if you write it, write down all the 14 of them. Are you with me? But we can say, for a practice, ready? We'll say 14 of them. Are you with me? Start. Innahu, innahuma, innahum, innaha, innahuma, innahunna, innaka, innakuma, innakum, innaki, innakuma, innakunna, inni, innana. See how easy it becomes and you understand. And there are two words. Inna is harfu tawqid wa nasb. And the pronoun is now here. Ismu inna. And what is ismu inna? Mansub. Are you with me? So in the book, second, the mansub forms will come now. Fine. Sister Halima, are you with me? Adkhil, enter inna in the following sentence. Huwa tajirun. Now this is again halwa puri, brother. This is a big halwa puri. How will you say by putting inna there? Innahu tajirun. Khalas, brother. So if you say innahu tajirun, okay, watch carefully. Huwa tajirun, huwa muftada, tajirun khabar. Now you put inna, so what will become inna hum? Inna, what will become to who? It is now ismu inna, no longer muftada. Are you with me? We cannot say it is muftada anymore. It is now ismu inna mansub. And then the khabar in that. Okay. Sister Arifa, number two. Ana talibun. Inni or innani talibun. So you know what is innani or inna. Fine. Sister Mamuna. Hinnahu min al-yabani. MashaAllah. Sister Nasreen. Athkiyahu. MashaAllah. Innakum. All of you are very intelligent. Zakiyun, intelligent. Azkiyahu is the plural. Af'ilahu. Agniyahu. Akviyahu. On that pattern. Fine. Sister Mehraj. Hiya mutazawijatun. Hiya. Innaha mutazawijatun. Innaha mutazawijatun. Nusrat. Nahnu. Innana. Or inna. Remember, inna or innana muslimuna. Fine. Sister Sumayya. Antunna mujtahidatun. This should not confuse you, brother and sister. I thought this was halwa puri. Inna kunna. See, that's why we practice pronouns. So that you should be very, very proficient. Inna kunna mujtahidatun. So inna kunna, how many words are there? Two. Inna harfu taqid wa nasb. Kunna ismu inna mansub. Mujtahidatun khabar. Sister Fatima, hunna muslimatun. Innahunna muslimatun. MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Sister Naima, anta rajulun ganiyun. Anta rajulun ganiyun. Innaka rajulun ganiyun. So when Brother Muhammad, when you ask that I want to go for shopping and ask for money, he said, no, I have no money. Then you can say, innaka rajulun ganiyun. You are a very rich man. I need some money. Okay, Sister Faiza. Anti zakiyatun. See, zakiyatun is your khabar, so it has to be anti. Anti. Inna ki. Zakiya. See, inna ki. This is very easy exercise. But you must write. All of them. You should write all of them, number three, number four. All of them you should write. This is very easy. See, Al-Mudarrisu Jadidun. What is Al-Mudarrisu? Mubtada. What is Jadidun? Khabar. Now bring Inna. So what will you say? Inna Al-Mudarrisa Jadidun. So Inna Harfu Tawqid Wa Nas. Ismu Inna Mansu. Khabar. This is the way it will be. Fatimatu Tabibatun. So what will you say? Inna Fatimata Tabibatun. Hamidun mutazawwijun. Inna hamidan mutazawwijun. Okay, now Sister Suhaina, adkhil inna in the following sentence and put proper vowel signs at the end. Inna darsa sahabun. So inna harfu taqid wa nasb and darsa ismu inna mansub and sahabun. Khabarinna. Are you with me, everybody? Brother Samad? Yes. Abdul Samad? Brother Saeed? Inshallah. Inshallah. Right. Sister Hafsa. You say inna, then what will you say? Inna sayara. You cannot say two. I warn you. It will cost you one dozen samosas. Okay? When you say inna, you cannot have sayaratu. It has to be sayarata. Brother, are you with me? See, that is why when you see inna in the Quran, you will always be looking for ismu inna mansub. Inshallah. Now, Brother Muhammad, beautiful sentence for you.
Inna al-Qur'ana.
Kitab. MashaAllah. You can analyze that also. Inna harfu taqid wa nasb. Quran, ismu inna mansub. Where is khabar inna?
Kitab.
Kitabu only. Wa huwa mudaf and mudaf ilahi. MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Inshallah. Brother Hassan.
Inna Muhammad
Rasulullah. Inna Muhammad Dan, 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 dan. Because Muhammad Dun has Tanween, so it will become Dan. Inna Muhammad Dan. How will you analyze, brother? Vanas. Muhammad Dan. Ismu Inna. Inna. Khabar. Rasulu. Wahuwa Mudah. Mudah. We got to be precise in our analysis. MashaAllah. Truly, Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Aminatu Talibatun. How will you say, Brother Abdul Samad? MashaAllah. Inna Aminata Talibatun. Analyze, Brother. Inna Harfu Tawqid.
Harfu Tawqid.
Wa Nasb.
Aminata.
Ismu Inna.
Inna.
Mansoob. Khabar inna. Okay. Okay. This is a very beautiful sentence. We should do it well. Brother, the sentence is this. Inna al-lughatal arbiya ta. Cannot be two. Why ta? Lughatal arbiya ta is in naat. Arbiya ta is in naat. Inna al-lughatal arbiya ta. Inna harfu tawqid wa nasb. Al-lughata ismu inna mansub. Al-arbiyata naat for lugha. And then where is our khabar? Sahalatun. Sahalatun is your khabar. Are you with me? Is everybody clear? I'll repeat one more time. Inna lughata al-arbiyata sahalatun. Inna harfu tawqid wa nasbin. Al-lughata ismu inna mansubun. Al-arbiyata Naat. And sahla tun, tun is your khabar inna. So khabar inna is marfu. So brothers and sisters, why it is al-arbiyata and not arbiyatu? Because the manawud is mansu. Where is manawud? Lugata. If lugata is manawud mansu, then naat has to be Mansur. We cannot say tu, it has to be ta, otherwise it will be wrong. I hope it is very clear. The Naat and Manut, they have a special relationship. Naat always follows Manut in its vowel signs, in its definite, indefinite, in its gender, and its number. Okay, brother? I always say jokingly, what a beautiful relation Naat Manut has. The Naat always follows Manut. I wish our children will become like Naat and follow the parents. Are you with me? Those who are young, they may not understand my joke. But when you will become parents and when you will have your own children, then you will be saying the same thing. Inna hadhihi. First, let us do this. Inna hadhihi. What is inna? Harfu tawqid wa nasb. What is hazihi?
Hazihi is
ismu inna mansub. Now it is mansub. See, hazihi doesn't change the form. Got the idea? Hazihi has only one uniform. Wherever you will invite her, she will come in the same uniform. So inna hazihi. So inna harfu taqid wa nasbin. Hazihi, because it is, came after inna, it is ismu inna mansubun. Are you with me? Ismu inna mansubun. And our favorite has come. What is that? But if the mubdal minhu, which is hazihi, from where the badal is derived, if you don't understand mubdal minhu, don't worry. What I'm trying to say, the badal, it must come from somewhere. It is coming from hazihi. Is hazihi marfu, mansub, majrur? Mansub. So then badal will become
Mansur.
Are you with me? Then the badal will become Mansur. Inna hadhihi sa'ata. Ghaliyatun is your khabar inna. Got the idea? Everybody got the idea? Inshallah? Sister Arifa? Inshallah. Sister Hafza? Inna bilalan gabiyun. What is the meaning of gabiyun? Not very intelligent. He's stupid, you know. Okay. It is the opposite of zakiyun. Okay? Inna Bilal. I'm glad we have no Bilal in our class. Inna Bilalan. Okay? Inna made the Bilalul into Bilalan. MashaAllah, you are getting there. But I think you got to watch your Badals and you got to watch your Naat. Huh? You got to watch your Naat. Sister Sukhaina. Inna al-mudira fil fasli. So, MashaAllah, MashaAllah. May Allah bless you and increase you in knowledge and all of us, brothers and sisters. You got the idea? Inna harfu taqid wa nasbin. Al-mudira ismu inna mansub fil fasli jar majrur shibu jumla khabar. Remember I told you the khabar can be five kinds. So here it is jar majrur shibu jumla khabar. Now, Sister Sumayya. Inna al-ma'a baridan. Truly the water is cold. We can say in Canada, when you open the cold water, it is cold, brother. Inna al-ma'a baridun. So ma'a is ismu inna mansu. Baridun is khabar inna. MashaAllah, MashaAllah. Khabar is of five kinds. Now if the khabar happens to be khabar inna, are you with me? If khabar happens to be khabar inna, then the khabar inna can be one word. Khabar inna can be jar majrur. Khabar inna can be this. Khabar inna can be anything. Now, okay, for the sake of practice, al kitabu jadidun. Put inna in front of it, sister. So what is jadidun? Now jadidun is khabar inna. Put khabar inna here, sister. Inna al-kitab al-maktabi. So what is now here? Kitaba is ismu inna. Where is the khabar? Al-maktabi. Jar majrur shibu jumla khabar inna. Yeah, you know. When you have inna, then we got to write down ismu inna and khabar inna. When it is only Mubtada, then we write down Mubtada and Khabar. If it is Inna, then Ismu Inna. And soon we will have Ismu Kana and Khabar Kana. Ismu Laisa wa Khabar Laisa. We will have. Okay, I'm not done. Sister Maimuna, you finish all. Innal. So where is the Khabar? Tahta is a Zarf. Shibu Jumla Khabar Inna. Are you with me? Because now we are dealing with inna. Okay, what would you say here? Inna. So inna hamidan became ismu inna. So where is the khabar inna? Zahaba ilal. Khabar inna. Now we say inna hamidan lahu thalathatu abna'in. So hamidan is ismu inna. Where is the khabar inna? The whole sentence is khabar inna. Okay, now put here inna. This is just for the sake of practice. Inna hamidan ahuhu tabibun. Truly the hamid, his brother is doctor. Fine. Then this becomes khabar inna. Are you with me? The next concept, brother and sister, is very important. But I think we should take a break now. Alhamdulillah, we are back now, brother and sisters. Now we do lesson number 7. We did finish lesson number 6. Al-ma'u baridun, Sister Fatima. Inna al-ma'a baridun. Baridun is khabar. And what is underneath, brother? As-sayaratu jamilatun. Mubtada khabar. Inna sayarata jamilatun. Ismu inna khabar inna. Now we are, mashallah, strong in this. We understand it very well. Now you have to follow two sentences and make other sentences according to the pattern of these two examples. Am min al-Hindi anta, am min Pakistan. Sahi? Now we already had our explanation. So when a and am comes and there are two things we are asking about, the first thing goes soon after Hamzatul Istifam. and then second thing follows am. Is it clear? You should underline it and try to, you know, make sure that you don't make mistakes, you know. Atabibun anta am muhandisun. Atabibun anta am muhandisun. If you say anta tabibun am muhandisun, that is incorrect. It has to be like this. Two things, both are separated. One comes after Hamzatul Istifham and the other comes after am. Now, I will start this time with brothers. Anta, then we have Mujtahidun, and then we have Kaslan. Now, Brother Muhammad, how will you use A and Am in here? Here, brother, you will say, A Mujtahidun Anta Am Kaslanu, diptote. A Mujtahidun Anta Am Kaslanu. Got the idea, brother? That's the way you got to do it. Maybe you should do one more. Okay. Asini Al-Yaban. Now here you got to use min. So use min with these two. Okay. What will you say? Aminasini. Here. Am min Al-Yabani. Khalas? Got the idea? Aminasini here. Am min al-Yabani, Sister Hafsa, you got it? Brother Hassan. Anta, tabi, anti, it has to be anti. Because it is tabibatun and mumaridatun. So what will you say? Yeah, that is the way it is. Tabibatun anti am mumaridatun with a question mark. Tabibatun anti am Mumarridatun, with a question mark. That's the way. Very good, brother. That's the way. I like it. Aha, aha. Okay. Brother.
Nasarahum am Yahudun.
Yahudun. MashaAllah. That is perfect, Brother Abdul Samad. That was perfect. May Allah bless you and all of us, inshallah. Amen. Now, Brother Saeed. We have here Masjidun, Madrasatun and Haza.
Haza, Masjidun, am Madrasatun.
No, then it will be wrong, brother. Masjidun Haza.
Masjidun Haza, am
Madrasatun. Got the idea?
Yeah.
Got to separate them. Cannot bring them together. Masjidun Haza, am Madrasatun, inshallah. Okay. We start with Sister Halima now. Go backwards. Sister Halima. Mudarrisi. Very good, brother. As-sayaratul mudiri hadihi am-sayaratul mudarrisi. Are you with me, brother? As-sayaratul mudiri hadihi am-sayaratul Mudarrisi. Remember, this is the most perfect, eloquent way of saying. If you say the other way, brother, it is wrong. We don't say that in Arabic. Okay? Sister Arifa? MashaAllah. Amutazabijun anta am azabun. Azabun means bachelor, brother. Okay, Sister Memuna? Ammatuka. Akhalatuka hunna am ammatuka. MashaAllah. That is the correct way. Now, Sister Nasreen, it is come Pakistan and Iran. Now, you can use min here. So, what will you say? You will have to say min, add min here. Amin. Pakistan. Huwa am min al-Irani, you can say. Am min al-Irani. Min Pakistana huwa am min al-Iran. Sister Mehnaz, aap kahenge? Yes. Karibun baituka am baitun. That was really beautiful. Okay. Brother, now we know ayu, kullu, and vu. Are you with me? And I told you, most of the time, in this case, the translation is done, not the grammar. Most of the time, translation is done, not the grammar. Okay, you just translate. What is the translation? Mudiruna zu lihyatin tawilatin. What is the translation? Our mudir has a long beard. That's all the translation. Are you with me? Are you with me, brother and sister? Our mudir, our director, has a long beard. That is the translation. Now, you don't go in the literal translation. Because zu means owner or possessor. So you don't say, our mudir is the owner and possessor of a long beard. But in Arabic, we'll say like that. Zu means he has. Okay? So we will English say, our director has a long beard. Now look at it, brother, carefully. I want you to find out Mubtada and Khabar. Are you with me? Watch the sentence carefully. Whose turn was there now? Nusrat? See, Mudiruna, how many words are there? Two. Mudaf, Mudafilihi. So where is our Mubtada? Mudiru is our Mubtada. Huwa Mudaf and Na Mudafilihi. Now where is our Khabar? Zu, in this case, zu will be your khabar. Sometimes zu can come as a naat. In this case, Sister Hafsa, zu is your khabar. Wa huwa mudaf. And there is mudaf ilayhi? Liyatin. And then what is tawilatin? Naat. See, Fatima? Liyatin tawilatin naat manud. Are you with me, everybody, brothers and sisters? So lihatin is the mudaf ilayhi and then tawilatin is naat. Got the idea? Inshallah. Now, Sister Sumayya, hazad daftaru mashara. These are beautiful sentences. This book has lined papers. That's all the English can say. This book has lined papers. Musat Tarin is the line. Okay, brothers and sisters? Ghairu musattarin will be plain paper. What is hada? Sister Sumayya? And what is the daftaru? Mashallah. Now, where is our khabar? Zu is your khabar. Wahuwa mudaf. And then mudaf ilihi. Got the idea? Alhamdulillah. That was beautiful. Now, sister Fatima, you got a tough question. Ahmadu talibun zu ilmin wa khulukin. So, what will you say, Ahmadu? Mubtada. Where is our khabar? Talibun. Talibun is your khabar. Are you with me? Talibun is your khabar. Okay, and then what is zu doing here? It is your naat here. Are you with me? Now zu is doing the job of naat. Wa huwa mudaf. And then what is ilmin? Mudaf lehi. Wa ataf and khulukin ma'tufun ala ilmin. How will you translate? Ahmed is a student with manners and knowledge. Okay. Ahmed is a, you can also say a good mannered and knowledgeable student. Are you with me? Ahmed is a well-mannered and knowledgeable student. Are you with me? Ahmadu talibun. Ahmed is a student. So talibun is your khabar. And zu comes soon after talibun. So zu is your naat. Wa huwa mudaf. And then mudaf ilayhi. Are you with me? Inshallah. Who is now Sister Naima? Hazal kamisu, again hazal kamisu, hada mubtada al kamisu, sita naima, badal. Okay, now we need our khabar. So where is our khabar? Zu. And then mudafilihi, kummin. What is kum mean? Sleeve. Huh? Kum mean kathirin. This is, my shirt is dhu kum mean tawilin. Short shirt will be dhu kum mean kathirin. Kum mean kathirin. Okay, brother and sister? Now look at my shirt. Hadal kamisu dhu kum mean tawilin. And anyone, it's winter, we don't have short shirts. But then if it is a short shirt, we'll say, Hazal kamisu zu kum min kathirin. Kum min is the sleeve. Are you with me, brother and sister? So zu is your, okay. Zu is your khabar. And zaka means zalika, mubtada. Where is the khabar? Zu. And then kum min is mudafilehi. And tawilin is naat. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Inshallah. This is a tough cookie. Isa, the last one is very interesting. Okay, Al-Masjidul Lazi. What is Al-Lazi? Sister Faiza, what is Al-Lazi? Ismu Mausula. Relative pronoun. Ismu Mausula. Okay? Fine. Al-Masjidul Ladhi fi Hayjina. Okay? I'm not going to go too much in detail. Inshallah someday we'll get it there. But Al-Ladhi when it comes, it always has a Silatul Mausul. Remember we did it, Silatul Mausul. In this case, Sister Faiza, where is Silatul Mausul? Fi Hayyina, mashallah. That was good. Put that into bracket, brothers and sisters. Put it into bracket. Allazi fi Hayyina. Fi Hayyina. Fi Hayyina, how many words are there? Three words. Fi, then Hayyi, and then Na. Okay, fine. Now, the masjid which is in our neighborhood, what about it? Where is the news? Zu, mashallah. Okay, so brother, where is our mubtada? Al-Masjid. That is your mubtada. And here I will say Al-Ladhi is a naat because it is describing it. What are you describing? And naat. First and foremost, we will always say ism mausula. And then we will say it is also a naat. In this case, it is naat. And then fi hayyina is our silatul mausul because it is connected with a allazi. Now, brothers and sisters, I know this is tough.
Can you say this is cover as well?
No. This is tough. But I do not want you to worry too much about it. If you understand, then I will say alhamdulillah. If you don't understand, then I will say don't worry. Because later on we are going to repeat these things over and over and over again. You know, and you will get it. So Sister Naima, please don't worry. If you get it, alhamdulillah. If you have little difficulty, just ignore it. Just translate. Okay. So, because we are doing analysis, so I just want to do it. Al-Masjidu, brothers and sisters, it is Mubtada. Al-Ladhi is Ismu Mausula, but it is coming as a Naat here. Because this is describing it. Okay? And then, fi hayyina, fi harfchar, hayyi sim majroor wa huwa mudaf, na mudaf ilahi. Now, this thing is a silatul mausul. This is silatul mausul, connected with allazi. Then, where is our khabar? Zu. That is your khabar. And then, it is mudaf. Manaratin, wahidatin. Wahidatin is your naat. Okay. Now, if you remove Al-Ladhi fi hayyina, what will you say, Sister Faiza? Remove Al-Ladhi and fi hayyina, what will you say? What will you say? The masjid has one minara. That's all. The masjid has one minara. Got the idea? So that is your, dhu is your khabar then. If you say Al-Masjidu, dhu, manaratin, Wahidatin, then zu is your khabar for masjid. Write down underneath, brother and sister, or on the side, What will you write down on the side? Al-Masjidu Zu Manaratin Wahidatin. Could you please write it down? Huh? So you know this is the actual sentence. But then we are describing the masjid in our neighborhood has single minara. Okay, brothers and sisters? Got the idea, Brother Muhammad?
Yes.
Inshallah. Everybody with me, brothers and sisters? Now, here, Dr. Abdurrahim wants us to practice. Now, this is again something that you will just try to do it. We won't go in detail too much. But the zu is singular. What is the plural of zu? Zavu. It is plural. And zu is a masculine. What is the monist of zu? Zatu. And if zatu is singular, what is the plural of zatu? Zavatu. Okay. Now, as I said, do not put yourself in too much stress to memorize it and you know, just take it lightly. Just do the exercise. Because over the time that we will be studying, you will get very strong, brother and sister. Look at this example. Haza talibu, what is haza? Mubtada. What is talibu? Badal. Where is the khabar? Zu khulukin. This student is well-mannered. This student is well-mannered. Fine. Now change that into plural. Haulai tullabu. What is haulai? Mubtada. What is attullabu? Badal. And then what is zavu? Our khabar. Wahuwa mudaf. And khulukin is mudafilehi. Very good, brother. Hazihi talibatu. What is hazihi? Mubtada. What is a talibatu? Badal. And then what is zatu? Khabar. Wahuwa mudaf. And then khulukin is mudafilehi. This female student is well-mannered. Fine. Haulai talibatu. Haulai talibatu. هؤلاء الطالبات ذوات خلق. So هؤلاء our مبتدا. What is الطالبات بدل. And what is ذوات is your خبر. وهو مضاف. And then مضاف إليه. Brother Muhammad.
Yes.
This is very simple if we try to analyze it. Okay. Otherwise ذو ذبو ذاتو ذواتو. If you remember, alhamdulillah. If you don't remember, don't worry. It will come in the lessons, inshallah. Now we've got to do our own. Brothers and sisters. هَذَا الرَّجُلُ ذُو مَالٍ كَثِيرٍ. Let us analyze this. هَذَا الرَّجُلُ بَدَلٍ. Where is our khabar? ذُو. And what is مَالٍ? مُدَافِلِهِ. What is كَثِيرٍ? نَات. Malin kathirin. Can I point out my finger to Brother Muhammad and say, Hazar Razulu Zu Malin kathirin? I can point out to Brother Abdul Samad and say, Hazar Razulu Zu Malin kathirin. Huwa tajirun.
Tajirun malin.
Now, how will you make it? Okay, Brother Rajulu, what is the monas of Rajulun? Al-Mara'atu. 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 Okay, sorry. First we have to do plural. Sister Suhaina, it is your turn now, sister. Make هذا الرجل into plural. Yes. Say it again, sister, one more time, loudly. See, هؤلاء الرجال, not رجالون. رجالو. Okay, badal. Okay, هؤلاء الرجال. Zavu Malin Kasirin. You write it down, huh, brother, inshallah. Now, then how will you say your sister Hafsa? Make it Hazar Rajulu into Muannas? No, Muannas now. Hadihi. Hadihil Mar'atu. What will you say? Hadihil Mar'atu. Zatu Malin Kathirin. Very good, mashallah. Now, brother, you have to say now.
Haulai.
Niatu. No, Nisaun. Mar'atu, plural is Nisaun. Haulai Nisa'u. Zawatu Malin Kathirin. Bas. Write it down with. At home, do this exercise, you'll become strong, inshallah. Are you with me? And the concept is very clear with you, inshallah. Okay, brother. This is again Halwa Puri. You will have no difficulty in doing it. We really want to finish the lesson so that we can start a new lesson tomorrow, inshallah. I have some handouts to give you. Please do collect your handouts. Because tomorrow, if possible, I'll explain you extra things about Inna. The things that we do in Book 3. But I want to do it now with you so that, you see, with Inna, something else comes in the Quran, and I want you to enjoy it and feel it in your heart. You know? So what is this extra thing? I'm going to leave the handout with you. You will read it, inshallah, and tomorrow I will explain you. It's so beautiful, brother. When you understand this, then, brother, there is nothing sweeter than Quran. There is nothing more eloquent than Quran. It is so beautiful. Then, you know, you will say, I just want somebody to recite Quran in Arabic, and I want to listen to it and understand it directly, inshallah. We said Inna has many sisters and La'alla is one of the sisters. So whatever Inna does, whatever Badi Behan does, Choti Behan also does the same thing. Okay, brother? Huwa bi khairin. Where were we? Now, brother Hassan. Huwa bi khairin. La'allahu bi khairin. Khalas. So when you say La'allahu, La'allahu min akhwatu in. La'alla min akhwatu Inna. At this juncture, we say it is the sister of Inna. La'alla min akhwatu Inna. Are you with me? Fine. And then what is who? Brother Hassan? What is who now? Ismu la'alla. It's easy. Brother, then also, Brother Hassan, you will say ismu la'alla mansubun. Are you with me? And what will you say? Bi khairin? Jar majrur. Shibu jumla khabar. Khabar of what? Khabar la'alla. Okay, do one more, brother. You got to do one more. Bi khairin. It's easy. So what is la'alla? What is la'alla? La'alla is min akhwatu inna. What is it? Min akhwatu inna. It is sister of inna. Say? La'alla min akhwatu inna. Okay, brother? Now tell me what is whom? Majroor. Shibu jumla, khabar, la'alla. Are you with me? Because now la'alla has come, so you will say ismu la'alla and khabar la'alla. Are you with me? When inna came, we said ismu inna and khabar inna. Now la'alla has come, we will say ismu la'alla and khabar la'alla. If la'kinna comes, then we will say ismu la'kinna and khabar lakinna. If anna comes, anna, then we'll say ismu anna and khabar anna. When if say ka'anna, so then you'll say ismu ka'anna and khabar ka'anna. If I say laita, ya laitani kuntu turab, you know, so that is also sister of inna. So if you say laita, then there will be ismu laita and khabar laita. Are you with me, brother? It's very simple. Inshallah, if you will practice, think about this. Ismu la'alla and khabar la'alla. What have the summit? Hiya bi khairin. La'allaha. Okay. Brother, I think let us brush up our 14 pronouns with la'alla. Ready? With a huwa. La'allahu, la'allahuma, la'allahum, la'allaha, la'allahuma, la'allahunna, la'allaka, la'allakuma, la'allakum, la'allaki, la'allakuma, la'allakunna, la'alli. What is it? La'alli. And then la'allana. La'allana. Okay, so, okay, you do one more, brother of the summit. La'allahunna bikhair. So, brother, what is la'alla? Min akhwatu inna. It is from the sisters of inna. And hunna became ismu la'alla. Ismu la'alla mansub. What will you say? Ismu la'alla mansub. Very good. And then what is then bikhairin? Jar majrur shubu jumla khabar. La'alla. Khabar la'alla. MashaAllah. Brother Saeed, you do the next one. Anta bi khairin. Anta will become la'alla ka. Bi khairin. Are you with me? La'alla ka bi khairin means I hope you are well. Okay? So la'alla is min akhwatu inna and ka is ismu la'alla mansubun. Is everybody following me? Inshallah. I'm repeating the same things, brothers and sisters. And there is the khabar of la'alla bi khairin. Jar majrur shubu jumla khabar. Got the idea, brother? Saeed, inshallah. Sister Arifa? Okay, describe it, sister. La'alla min akhwatu inna. Ki ismu la'alla mansub. Sahih? Huh? And then bi khairin. Jar majrur shubu jumla khabar la'alla. Okay, Sister Nasreen. Ana najihun. La'alli najihun. La'alli najihun. Well, how will you translate? You have given your examination. Now you are saying, La'alli najihun. I hope I will pass. Or I will, I'm the one who will pass. I hope I pass. I hope I pass. I am the one who has najihun, the one who is successful in the exam. Okay? So if you say la'alli, la'alla min akhwatu inna, where is the ismu la'alla? Ya mutakallim. Are you with me? How will you write down, brothers and sisters? La'alli. How many words? Two. Okay? La'alla min akhwatu inna. Ya mutakallam ismu la'alla mansubun. And where is the khabar? Najihun. Are you with me? Yes, Sister Maynaz. La'allana najihun. We hope we are successful. Are you with me? So, la'alla min akhwatu inna and na. Ismu la'alla mansub and najihuna is your khabar. Najihuna is your khabar. Are you with me? La'alla min akhwatu inna na ismu la'alla najihuna khabar la'alla. That's the way, inshallah. Now, Sister Nusrat. Al-Mudira. Ghurfatiha. What is the translation? I hope the mudir is in his room. So, la'alla al-mudira. La'alla al-mudira. Like, inna al-mudira. Same way, la'alla al-mudira. Fil ghurfati. So, fil ghurfati is your jar majrur shubu jumla khabar. Okay? And la'alla mudira. It means naqatu inna al-mudira. Ismu la'alla mansub. Very good. Now, this is a very nice sentence, Sumayya. You will always say this when you write exam. What will you say? La'alla al-ikhtibara. Ikhtibara. Remember, it's easy. Don't forget. Ismu la'alla or mansub. La'alla al-ikhtibara sahlun. Can you translate? See, la'alla can either show hope or fear. These are all hope, showing all hope. لَعَلَّ الْإِخْتِبَارَ سَهْلٌ MashaAllah, that's all you hoped. I hope the examination is easy. So where is the ismu لَعَلَّ الْإِخْتِبَارَ Where is khabar? سَهْلٌ MashaAllah, that was beautiful. Now, in the next lesson, brothers and sisters, we are coming across a verb. What are we coming across? I will use 3-4 minutes to tell you a little bit. We haven't done our verbs. Here is a verb, brother. What is the verb? Laysa. This is a very nice verb, brother. This is not regular verb. This is a weak verb. Laysa. What is in the middle? There's ya. And also ya has a sukoon. Now we have to remember that in Arabic, two sukoons cannot come together. Cannot come. Because you cannot pronounce. And if the two sukoons come, then if one of the two sukoon is a weak letter, then we drop it. So ya is dropped then. If the two sukoons come, ya is dropped. Ready? Start conjugating. Laysa, laysa, laysu, laysat, laysata, and then we stop because hunna special condition. What are the conditions for hunna, brother? Watch this. Laysa, and then we put hunna. Are you with me? Now, first radical, second radical, third radical. Fa kalima, ain kalima, lam kalima. When hunna comes, condition is the lam kalima should get a sukoon. If I put sukoon here, then there is a sukoon here. No, I have a problem. I cannot pronounce. So then, I drop it. Yeah. Why I drop the ya? Because it is a weak letter. Ya and vau are weak letters when they come in the verb. Okay? So, brothers and sisters, what will be now? Lasna. If I know lasna, brother, then where I am now? If I know lasna, where I am now? I'm 407. When I come to lasna, where I am now? I'm 407. So I know what to do next. Speed up. What will I say? Lasta, lastuma, lastum, lasti, lastuma, lastunna, lastu, lasna. So simple, brother. Can you say fast like me? Try it. Lasna, lasta, lastuma, lastum, lasti, lastuma, lastunna, lastu, lasna. Ta tumatum, ti tumatunna, tuna. That's all. So now you do the whole thing. Laysa, laysa, laysu, laysat, laysata, lasna. Lasta, lastuma, lastum, lasti, lastuma, lastunna, lasna. Lastu, lasna. Brother and sister, if we do not understand this concept, then you will say, what kind of a, where are we going? When you say lasna, where did the ya go? But why did ya disappear? Because when you came to hunna, the condition was the third radical should get a sukoon. When we gave the third radical sukoon, we ended up with having two sukoons. And now that is not possible in Arabic. So one of the sukoon has to be given a pink slip. We all understand in Canada pink slips. Okay? So we gave a pink slip to ya and you said, bhai, you take a vacation now. And then what is left now? Lasna. What is left now, brother? Lasna. Brother and sister, try to conjugate this on a piece of paper. Now we come to number 12. Ikra. Ikra al-mithalaini. Thum makra jumla al-atiyata. Ba'd zalik. Uktubha ma kitabati. A'dadi. Waridati fiha bil-huruf. Now you see, you have to write down in letters. The numbers, you have to write down in letters. Let us first try to understand. We haven't done from 11 to 99 yet, which we'll be doing very soon. Okay. We have done from 1 to 2. In that case, the number is coming always as a nath. And then from 3 to 10, there is a relationship of mudaf ilayhi. The number comes as a mudaf, and the thing counted, al-madud, comes as a mudaf ilayhi. But it is always in jama. But then starting from 100, also the relationship is mudaf ilayhi. But now mudaf ilayhi is singular. What is it, brother? Singular. That's all we have to remember. Okay? So, 100 men, what will you say? Miyatu rajulin. 100 women. Miyatu again, mudaf ilayhi. It cannot be miyatun. Has to be miyatu, miyatul mar'ati. Mar'atin. Miyatu mar'atin. Sahi, brothers and sisters? And then, 1,000 men, alfu rajulin. Not rijal. No. Only 3 to 10. Okay? And then, 1,000 women, alful mar'atin. Alful mar'atin. But then now we have to do it in writing. Nusrat, hazal telfazu bi alfi riyalin. What will you say, sisters? Bi, you write like this, bi alfi riyalin. It's easy. Got the idea? You saw 1,000 there. 1,000 riyal will be alfu riyalin. Now comes b, it will become b alfi riyalin. Khalas. How many words are there? B alfi riyalin. Three. B harf jar. Alfi ism majrur wa huwa mudaf, and then riyalin mudaf ilayhi. Okay. Sister Sumaya, next one. In the alfu dolarin, mashallah. In the alfu dolarin. Okay. Not alfun, because it is mudaf. Okay. So, you are a rich lady, Sumaya. You got $1,000, Okay. In the, so what is in the, brothers and sisters? In the is zarf, shibu jumla khabar. And ya mutakallim is mudaf ilayhi. So where is our mubtada? Alfu, wa huwa mudaf, and riyalin mudaf ilayhi. Correct? Are you with me, Sister Sumaya? You got it? Inshallah. Fatima, fi hazal kitabi, what is it? Miyatu safatin. Miyatu got the idea? Miyatu safatin. Why it is miyatu? Because there is no harf jar in front of it. There is no nothing in front of it. So, how will you now analyze it? Fi hazal kitabi. Fi harf jar. What is haza? Ism majrur. Okay. And then, what is al kitabi? Badal. I cannot say mudaf ilayhi. No, it's badal. Fine, brother. Fi hadha jar majrur shibbu jumla khabar. Now where is our mubtada? Miyatu. Wa huwa mudaf, and then safatin mudaf ilahi. Got the idea? Now, sister Naima, become hadhihil hakibatu. How much is this handbag for? Answer is hiya bi miyati. B came it became miyati riyale. What? How will you write down? B miyati riyalin. Tell me, brothers and sisters, how many words are there? Three. B arfchar miyati isam majrur huwa mudaf mudafili. Inshallah. Got the idea, Sister Naima? Sister Suhaina? Fi hadhihi al-kulliyati. Now, see, if you understand fi hadhihi al-kulliyati, and, okay. One second, Sister Suhaina. Okay, brothers and sisters, I keep your pencils always handy. I will try to point out to you the separation of Mubtada Khabar, so that those who are not very strong will find it easy. Starting from number one, Hadal Tilfazu, put a line. So that means you are separating your Mubtada and Khabar. In the, put a line. Got the idea? Fi Hadal Kitabi, put a line. Just one line, like this, you know. Okay, separate them. In order to understand it well. Here, put a line. Got the idea? Sister Hafza, are you understanding me? Sister Abir, inshallah. Fi hadhihi al-kulliyati, put a line. This will make your job easy, inshallah. Okay, Sister Suhaina. Fi, what is fi? MashaAllah, MashaAllah. May Allah bless you. And all of us, inshallah. So, fi hadhihi al-kulliyati. Fi, Sister Suhaina? Is the majrur? Badal. See, put a line. So, tell me the khabar. Fi hadhihi. No. Fi hadhihi, jar majrur, shibu jumla khabar. Yes. Now we put a line, now we come to the mubtada. Miyato is mubtada. Wahua mudaf, talibin mudaf ilahi. And min Pakistan, jar majrur. Then again, wow came. Ataf. Now this miyatu can be ma'tufun ala other miyatu. Are you with me? Wahua mudaf, and talibin mudafilehi, min Indonesia. Got the idea, brothers and sisters? Inshallah. Kawwin, jumlan. Kawwin jumlan, musta'milan. Kalimatil atiyata. Okay, brothers and sisters, make simple sentence. Life is very complicated. Don't make it more complicated. Make simple sentence. Zakiyun. How will you make a sentence? Zakiyun? Sister Abir? Yes, the student is. You can even say, Ana Zakiyatun. I'm smart. At-talibu, the student is clever. So she used at-talibu, you know, muftada. If she had said talibun zakiyun, then it would have been just not manut. It would not have been a sentence. You can say Muhammadun, now it is definite. Muhammadun talibun zakiyun. Now zakiyun came as a naat. Muhammad is a intelligent student. Fine. Sister Hafsa? B. When you say price, you use B. Hazal kitabu B miyati riyalin. Hazal kitabu B miyati riyalin. Brother Muhammad? Mutazawwijun. Haza waladun mutazawwijun. Translate, brother.
This son is married.
This is a married boy. Okay. If you say this boy is married, then you would have said Hazal waladu mutazawwijun. Or you can say Hazal rajulu, better. Hazal rajulu mutazawwijun. Even More simpler will be ana mutazawwijun. What is the meaning?
I'm married.
Okay. Ana mutazawwijun. Okay, fine. Brother Hassan? Yeah, okay, good brother, you made a try. But as I said, life is very complicated. Don't make it more complicated. Just say, Muhammadun Azabun. Muhammad is bachelor. Inshallah, when we have a control over Laisa, then you can use that, inshallah. Or you can say, or we can say, Huwa Azabun. He is bachelor. You can say, fine. Khulukun. Al-waladu? No, you will have to say zu. Al-waladu zu ilmin wa khulukin. Al-waladu, or you can even say Muhammadun zu khulukin. Muhammad has good manners. Okay, brothers and sisters? In the Alfu Dularin. Yes, they're absolutely correct. I have 1,000 in the Alfu Dularin. Very good. MashaAllah. Salim, you want to do it? See, here your wife is correcting you. MashaAllah. Hazihi Saatu. What will you say? Hazihi Saatu. This watch. هَذِهِ السَّاعَةُ غَالِيَةٌ مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ. That was good, Nusrat. Alhamdulillah. So, you got the idea, brothers and sisters? ذَكِيٌ الْكَلِمَةُ الْجَدِيدَةُ ذَكِيٌ جَمَا أَذْكِيَاءُ سَهِ أَفْئِلَاءُ Okay. أَغْنِيَاءُ أَكْوِيَاءُ Fine. غَبِيٌ Stupid. Same wazan, aghbiya'u, diptot, aghbiya'u, mamnu min as-sarf. Khulukun, everybody knows akhlaq, very common word, akhlaq. Mi'atun, remember, if it is not mudaf, then it is mi'atun. And it can become mi'atan, and it can become mi'atin. Yes. Alfun, alfan, alfin, it can become. Rubiyatun, of course, only country now with rupees is India and Pakistan. Rubiyatun, Rubiyatun, Jama Muanas Salim. Mutazawwijun, married. Azabun, bachelor. What is the plural? Azabun, Azabun. Yahudiyun, singular. What is plural? Yahudun. Yahudun. Okay. Mu'ajamun. Dictionary. Ma'ajimu. What is the wazan? Ma'ajimu. Mafa'ilu. Give me another example. Always give the example. Masajidu. Very simple to remember. Masajidu is mafa'ilu. If you see any noun coming on this pattern, you will always be able to point out it is the wazan of mafa'ilu. And it is very important pattern, brothers and sisters. Dularun, dularatun. So brothers and sisters, dularatun, we won't call it muannas. It will still be muzakkar. Because dularun is muzakkar. Are you with me? Safhatun, safahatun. Najihun, successful. Jama Mudhakar Salim. Najihuna. Najihuna. Then Galin. Are you with me? If you want, put a line, bracket, and write down Galiyatun. Just for you to understand, you know. When it became oneness, the Ya became visible. Galin. What is it, brother? Galin. From the looks of it, it is majrur. Isn't it majrur? There are two kasras there. Are you with me? Tanween, kasra. So kasra is a sign of majroor. Kasra is a sign of majroor. From the looks of it, it's majroor. But it is not majroor. It is marfu. Now, I would love to show you the details, but I think the time is not right. This thing we study in detail in book 3, how certain nouns take this form, that they end up with two kasras. The other example is qadin. What is it? Qadin. Other example is wadin. Another example is fi'lun madin, not fi'lun madun, fi'lun madin. Are you with me? Again two kasras. And then there is muhamin, muhamin. Are you with me? Because Dr. Saab has not given us details, so I'm not going to go in details in this particular case. But when you will come to book 3, we will study it, and it's very interesting. Now, ghalin, it's marfu, brothers. Remember, it is marfu. But when you make it muannas, then something you see like this. Where did this ya come from? Because it is there. Galin is actually galiyun. Kadin is actually kadiyun. And wadin is actually wadiyun. And madin is actually madiyun. And then muhamin, muhamiyun. Okay? But when there's a ya there, and before it if there's a kasra, the ya is dropped. Okay? Ya is dropped, and it gets one extra compensatory kasra. Don't worry about it, because I don't want to go in detail. Brothers and sisters, we will understand more when we do the verbs. So it is written like this, galin, which is actually galiyun, but we write it like galin. When you make it muannas, then ya becomes visible to you. Are you with me? Now it became visible to you. Okay? So kadin, make it muannas, female kadi, kadiyatun. Okay? Fine. Muhamiyatun. Okay? So these are the things that will happen when you make it muannas. This is enough for now. This is enough for now, inshallah. Later on, we will go in detail, brother. So, if you have to use ghalin as marfu, then it will be without ya. And if you have to make it into muannas, then the ya will come out. When it is marfu, the ya does not come out. It's you see like galin. Are you with me? Inshallah, this explanation is enough. So we say, hazal kalamu galin. Asluhu galiyun. Is it clear, brothers and sisters? Hazal kalamu, haza mubtada, al kalamu badal. Where is our khabar? Galin, one word. It has to be marfu. Galin is not majroor, but it is marfu. Do you see galin? It's marfu. This pen is expensive. Galiyun change into galin. I beg your pardon? That's why I didn't want to explain. Okay? I didn't want to explain because it will put a lot of stress on us. Dr. Abdurrahim has no choice but to use the word garland opposite rakhis. Now, I explained to you, Sister Mahmuna, that when you have a noun like this, ghaliyun, okay, look at the construction. What is before ya? What is before ya? Kasra. Is it before kasra? Before ya, is it kasra? Yeah. When before ya is a kasra, tanween and kasra, then we cancel the ya. Okay? And now because there is a tanween there, we compensate this by giving extra kasra. Are you so ghaliyun became ghalin. Where this extra kasra came? It is compensation for cancelling the ya. Now, you know, at this stage, you will find it difficult to digest. So I didn't want to go in detail. So that's why I say ghalin is actually ghaliyun, but you never write ghaliyun. You will always write ghalin. If I say hadhar rajulu, in English I say this man is a judge. So how will I say in Arabic? Hadhar rajulu qadin. What will I say? Qadin. This man is a lawyer. He's an attorney. What will he say? Hadhar rajulu muhammin. But actually it is muhammiyun. And there are many more things happening. Like, you know, dun dan din. And then what happens when it is mansub? It's too much detail now. It's not necessary to go in detail. Just understand ghalin is marfu here. It's marfu here. Fine, brother and sister. Sahih, brother? Muhammad? Just for your information, you write down ghalin and then ghaliyatun. Both are marfu. Kummun, sleeves, brother. Kummun is sleeves. And then akmamun. Akmamun is your jama. Alhamdulillah, we did lesson number 1.